the first sequence starts from a standing position and is followed by a deceleration phase. The second and the third starting from a rising speed, and the athlete reach the goal line on the opposite side of the pitch. This sequence was repeated 6 times, is quite clear in this graph. Above you can see the time course of the speed, and below the time course of the acceleration. We zoom on a single sequence. So let's start from the top of this picture. So the athlete now is standing corresponding to the goal line, and the speed is equal to 0, and he starts to accelerate. So during the acceleration phase, he crosses the acceleration threshold, enters in the green zone, and reaches the acceleration peak. So in this case, the acceleration is not 6 meters per second square, like we have seen before in the paper, but only 4 meters per second square, because it's not a maximal effort. So he remains in the green zone for 1 second, and the two conditions together results in an acceleration event. And once the first acceleration phase is over, the athlete reaches the top speed, which is lower than 7 meters per second. And the acceleration in this point goes to 0. This is the point number 2. So the deceleration phase follows and ends when the athlete reaches a rising speed of about 3 meters per second.